The Institute of Food Research is the only publicly funded research institute in the UK that addresses the fundamental understanding, the fundamental science of food and health. It asks fundamental questions such as how does the gut work, how does it interact with food, and how that relates to the process of aging and to disease processes. At the moment in the United Kingdom and most of the developed world, the public health burden is enormous and increasing due to food-related illnesses, diabetes, obesity, and so forth. Institutes are there for the longer term, and the research undertaken has got a very clear strategic aim to address these problems in society.
Our work on natural products is aimed at providing the science to underpin the five-a-day message. In other words, what we're trying to understand is why eating five portions of fruits and vegetables give the protective effects for various diseases that they do. So a lot of the work is mechanistic and looking at how these compounds are digested, how they break down, and how they deliver the benefit.
An example of fundamental research which has benefited from long-term investment by the government's funding for science at IFR is the development of a form of broccoli which has got a very high content of the active ingredient in there which promotes health.
We're interested in food structure and how food structure changes and breaks down in the gastrointestinal tract, because this not only affects the release and availability of nutrients, but the food structure can also impact microbiological populations in the gut, which also have health implications.
The gut is the inner tube of life. It's absolutely essential to preserve and sustain life. It's important because it processes the food that we take in on a daily basis. It breaks it down, makes it more accessible as an energy source for the body. Without the gut, we would essentially starve to death very quickly. So one of the technologies that we are developing is a bioimaging technology, where we're hoping to be able to visualize in real time microbe interactions with the gut epithelium and the gut immune system. We also have here at the Institute a model gut or model colon, which is a system, a continuous fermentation system, which allows us to culture the microbes that are present in the human colon. And this provides us with a means by which we can investigate and interrogate their function, which is impractical and ethically cannot be carried out in humans. So it's an important technology that allows us to be able to study the function of this vast collection of microbes that resides in the human gastrointestinal tract.
A core part of IFR's research relates to working with foodborne pathogens and how they grow. And how they grow particularly on food. Not just on food as it grows, food as it's processed, food as it's transported, food as it's stored in the supermarket shelves. This has been analysed, put into a big database, so that manufacturers or academics or anyone interested can work out what the best possible combination of processes is to ensure the minimum risk of contamination by foodborne pathogen.
We also have an extensive program on the main microbiological organism, Salmonella campylobacter, and we have a particular niche expertise in Clostridium botulinum, and we have a facility here that's able to handle that organism, and that represents a sort of national resource.
The Institute employs about 210 people. It has an annual budget of just over 15 million a year. And of that, something like £1 million a year comes from industrial sources. The BBSRC, which is our sponsoring institute, provides a core grant of just under 10 million. And the remainder comes from a wide variety of sources. IFR works in partnership with a huge range of organizations and institutions. We have to have good relationships with the food industry. We have to be able to work in a multidisciplinary way with clinicians, with nutritionists, with plant scientists, with agricultural scientists, with genome specialists to move forward.